Francesca from Under the Covers, and today I have a discussion video. It's not going to be a review, it's just a discussion of my thoughts on The Savior by J.R. Ward. This is book 17 in the Black Dagger Brotherhood series, and I'm calling this a discussion video because I do want to talk about certain things that I have some issues or concerns with in regards to The Savior. It's going to be spoilery. It's probably not necessarily so much of a review and more so how this dealt with my expectations. Another thing that I want to point out is the fact that I rated this book 3 stars. However, Suzanne enjoyed it a lot more than me, and she actually rated it 4.5 stars, and her review is already posted on the blog, so I will leave a link to her thoughts on the book in the information box down below. And like I said, this is going to be a little spoilery, so if you have not read this book or you don't want to be spoiled, maybe skip this video and watch it after you've read it. And let me know if you agree with me on any of these things or what your thoughts are on any of the things that I'm going to point out. I would love to get your opinion or just to know if I'm the only one that feels the way I do. So let's just jump right into it. Like I said, I rated this 3 stars. The first thing that I want to mention is the fact that this book felt a lot like the original Black Dagger Brotherhood books. There's a very small element of the big bad of the story, and there's a lot more focus on the couple, the main couple, and a lot less of the side storylines that we've been getting in the past few Black Dagger Brotherhood books. That could be a really good thing. I feel like it's nice to have the storyline a little bit more focused, but I'm also of the opinion that I didn't necessarily feel that having so many storylines was confusing. I actually enjoyed it. I think it gave me a really well-rounded view of the world. So I'm happy about that, but at the same time, there was that full picture of the world that I was missing. Now, this was sort of an important book, I feel like, in terms of the main character. This was Murder's book, and murder has been around in the Black Dagger history for basically since the beginning of the series. We have heard about him. We know that he had a previous relationship with Hex, and that's now John Matthews Shellen. So I was really looking forward to seeing that interaction and that history explored. So starting with that, that's actually one of the things that I enjoyed, is the fact that we didn't go into any unnecessary drama with the relationship between John Matthew and Hex. And there was none of the, is she going to cheat or none of that. So I was really happy to see that, and that was addressed, I think, really early on. So I think in terms of that, I was very happy with how she handled it and how she put that relationship into the storyline. But bringing murder back into the Black Dagger Brotherhood also has other things that needed to be addressed and explored. He was kicked out of the Black Dagger Brotherhood, and we get to finally see what the reason was for that, what actually drove him insane. And this was one of the things that I had the biggest issue with, was how the Black Dagger Brotherhood addressed both what happened in the past, how he was kicked out, and then how he's reinstated into the fold. I think some of the problems that I had with that, other than how the Black Dagger Brotherhood actually acted towards this, was Hex's role in that whole situation, because murder basically took the blame for some of her actions in the past. And obviously she's had plenty of opportunities to come clean, even if she didn't want to back then. She's now part of basically the Brotherhood. She's very close to all the brothers, and she still never felt like it was the right thing to do to speak up until very late in this book. I just didn't understand how she let that go on for so long, how she let him take the blame for something she did, how she never spoke about what was done to him. So I didn't really appreciate the position that that puts Hex's character in, because I've always really admired her strength, and to me it was really not a nice move in terms of what she did in the past and also how she handled it now. And I also feel like it was really brushed off really easily, because towards the end of this book, when everything comes to light, And then we have an off-page moment where Hex comes clean to the brothers, and then all of a sudden everything is forgiven and he's asked to be back in the Brotherhood. And basically in just a couple of easy conversations, it's as if nothing ever happened. And there's probably at least a century of just stuff that gets brushed under the rug, and to me that was very unrealistic, and I wasn't a big fan of how that makes me see the Brotherhood in general, especially how they acted in the past. But now in the present, it's also making it seem as if it's so easy for something to be fixed and forgotten. Another one of my big issues with the book was all the missed opportunities. I think that the story was very basic, and that also at times made it a little boring for me. But there was so much more that could have been explored, in my opinion. Especially, I think that we could have seen a lot more of the connection between Murder and Darius, and now, obviously, with John Matthew. I think that she barely touched on that. And I think that those moments could have been a lot more powerful if maybe we would have explored a little bit more that connection, or even seen some of their past interactions, or maybe having some of the fight scenes where Murder and Darius were together. I think it would have just made the story richer, and it would have made it more emotional, I think, as well. Now, in terms of the bigger overarching plot and bad guy, I feel like this book felt a lot like a filler because we're still not really getting a lot of progress with what Thro is doing, and then Davina's coming in, and there wasn't a whole lot going on in this one in terms of that big overarching plot, and it really felt like a filler book in terms of that conflict. So if that was the case, I really wanted the romance then to be really, really strong, and this is now where I will talk about the main romance and chemistry between Murder and Sarah. And honestly, they felt a little two-dimensional and cookie cutter, and while yes, there is some chemistry between them and I like them good enough, it was very insta-lovey. I think out of most of the Black Dagger Brotherhood books, this probably feels the most like a Fated Mates storyline. Murder had actually seen her before, and this could just be personal preference. I'm not really big into Fated Mates and insta-love, but to me that really made their story feel a little bit less intense and have less connection, in my personal opinion. Obviously, that doesn't mean that I didn't like the page time that we got from them or their interactions. I just didn't really buy into the forever kind of love between them, especially that short amount of time. And then when it comes to relationship issues and conflict, I think that the main conflict that was brought on as a side storyline with John Matthew and Hex was also not all that deep. I'm not sure what a better conflict would have been for the two of them. Obviously, I didn't want any of the cheating possibilities, but I really wanted something that would have made their relationship stronger, and I don't think that's what we got in this story. Now, one thing that I really enjoyed was the ceremony with John Matthew becoming a brother and the role that Murder had to play in that moment. I think that it was perfect. It was perfect that Thor and Murder were the ones that inducted him basically into the Brotherhood. It was really beautiful. And again, I think missed opportunity. I really wanted more of the Darius connection. And I think last I want to touch on Murder's insanity, because that's what I was expecting. I was expecting a character that is insane. That's why he was kicked out of the Brotherhood. And to me, he felt really normal. There was really nothing that made him any different from any of the brothers. And I don't think that all his torture and everything he experienced in the Sympath colony, I don't think that was explored. So I think that there could have been a lot more that we could have done with that scenario and that situation, and it would have made Murder a different type of character. I don't think that the Murder we get in this book is the Murder that I was expecting to get. I think overall The Savior is one of the least emotionally heavy books in this series, and to me that's what I read Jair Ward for. I want her to draw out all my emotions and really get me invested in this story, and I don't think we got quite there with this book. I wanted something really emotional, and there was nothing in the story that pulled at the strings of my heart, and I'm really sad to say that. It didn't have a ton of deep, intense emotion. It didn't have a lot of humor, because there were only just a few moments with Rage or with Lassiter that drew out any kind of funny moments. So overall, I found this kind of blah and boring in comparison to other Black Dagger Brotherhood books. So take this all in the context of the fact that I really enjoyed the story and I still rated this 3 stars. So it's by no means a book that I did not like reading. It's just more expectations versus reality. I have certain expectations from this series. I had expectations for this book. And I feel like we've gone a different lane from every angle in this book, from emotion to storyline to plot to characters and what they're supposed to be like, what I was expecting them to be like, conflict, and just basically everything. Now, the Black Dagger Brotherhood is probably still my most beloved series, and J.R. Ward is still an author that I continue to read, and I'm still excited to pick up her next book. But I'm just really curious to see if any of you felt the same about any of the things that I talked about in this video. So that's why I wanted to do a little bit of a discussion video. So I'm definitely looking forward to seeing your comments on this. And honestly, guys, this is probably one of the hardest videos I've had to film because I always love to praise this series, and it's a series that I usually really, really enjoy. And this was one of those books in the series that was really important to me because it was so highly anticipated, and that's basically the reason why I just had to get my feelings out and see if anybody else feels the same. And I think that about covers it, so I can't wait to see what you guys have to say. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up if you like the video, and hit subscribe so you don't miss any of our videos. You can find us on the blog at underthecoversbookblog.com and all our social media channels. All the links will be in the information box down below. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and we'll see you again in the next video. Bye bye.